So let's look at creating a shortcut in the Shortcuts app on iOS that will put a watermark on top of a photo. This is handy if you want to kind of imprint your name or logo or something of our photo before you share it in some way. So we're going to go into the Shortcuts app. If you don't have it, of course you get it in the iOS App Store. It's the Shortcuts app from Apple. And we go into Library here, and then I'm going to create a shortcut. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to get the watermark. So I'm going to use get file as the action there. I'm going to drag that over. And I'm going to grab the watermark from iCloud Drive. You could choose another service that you have like Dropbox. I could also use a completely different action to grab it from the Photos library. But I want to use a cool little graphic that I made. So it's going to be saved as a file. So I'm going to get it from there, and I'm going to show the document picker. Allow me to pick out the watermark. I could turn that off and then actually set the path to that file. So then if I'm just using the same watermark over and over again, it could be really handy. It skips a whole step. But I'm going to stick with Show Document Picker. Now the next thing I'm going to do is, now that I've picked that, I want to get the input. So I want to specify that this shortcut's going to take images. The way I'm going to do this is I'm going to hit the settings there at the top right. It's the two little buttons there under Done, the one on the right there. And I'm going to say I want it to be in Share Sheet, not a widget. And once I do it with Share Sheet, it says this shortcut accepts anything. I'm going to tap anything and deselect all and say I just want images. Great. Now I want to get a variable, and I'm going to put it there, and I'm going to say choose variable. I'm going to say select a magic variable, which allows me to take the output from a previous action. And one of those previous actions is the shortcut input. You can see I only have two. Shortcut input in green, and then in purple the file that I've chosen. I want to actually get the shortcut input. Great. So now I've chosen the file for the watermark, and now I've gone back to saying, hey, okay, now let's deal with the input that's come in here, the image that was chosen, the photo. Now I'm going to use the overlay image action there. And what image am I going to overlay? Well, I'm going to say choose variable, and now I can say select magic variable again, but this time I'm going to choose file. Choose the file. Now I could show the image editor, and that's really neat because that allows you to actually place the watermark. But instead I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to say position is bottom right. Width and height I'm going to leave on auto. And opacity, you know what, I'm going to change that to 50%. So it's kind of going to semi-fade in there. Great. So now what happens when it's done? Well, I love to use the Quick Look action because Quick Look basically will display the results and then allow you to share it from there. This means that I don't have to tie myself into saying, well, this is going to be sent as a text message or this is going to be posted to some social media network or something. At that point, you could decide what you want to do with it. You could just save it as a file. So now I've got all this stuff. Let's go and go to the settings again and let's name it. Call this Watermark 2 because I already have a Watermark 1. It's set to show and share sheet, accept image type, accept types images, and we're good. Except that there's one more thing we need to do, and you see this a lot in shortcuts. We need to add something called continue shortcut in app. And this is because sometimes when you get stuck inside of a thing like a share sheet there where we're going to share this image, a lot of these functions don't work anymore. So what we're going to do is we're going to put continue shortcut in app, and it's going to jump to the Shortcuts app to run all of this stuff. Without this, it just wouldn't work right. That's why you see continue shortcut in app a lot. So we'll hit done, and now we'll go and try it out. We'll go to the Photos app. We'll choose a photo. I'll hit the share button at the top, and now I'll go and find shortcuts. Tap that, and then choose Watermark 2. And then you can see it's going to jump to the Shortcuts app. So you can see that in the background there. I'm going to choose from my iCloud Drive the image I want for the watermark, which is that first one right there. It's going to load it in and then show me the image. And notice at the bottom right hand corner, that nice little MacMost logo is now imprinted on top of the photo. So I'm set. And because this is the Quick Look here, I can use the share button at the top right, and now I can share it all sorts of different ways. Or if I just want to test to see it's working, I can hit done and I'm good. Now I want to show you what happens if I were to change this in the overlay image. Instead of having it set to bottom right, I could turn that off and have it show image editor. So now when I go and I try to do the same thing, you can see I'm still sharing there. So I go to shortcuts, I'll share again, I'll select the image, and now the image is right in the top there. And I could drag it around with my finger. I could shrink it down with two fingers. I have the opacity there button, so I can change it. I can even rotate it. I can hit done, and now it's wherever I want it to. So I could position it in different places. So it's kind of handy to do that as well. You can decide which one you want to do when you create this. So I wanted to show you how I made this graphic here. This is Acorn. You can use Pixelmator, you can use Photoshop, anything you want. But notice that I have the checkerboard background here, meaning this is transparent. If you don't create a transparent image, you're of course going to have a white background or whatever. It's just going to be a rectangle that you're using as a watermark. Making a transparent image is very useful. And I didn't have to use a logo here. I could have actually just, you know, used some text like with my name and stuck that, you know, as a watermark. You want to, of course, make it large enough so that it, you know, fills the corner here. In this case, it's a 800 by 250. And you think about the size of a photograph and how big you want this to be in the bottom corner. So make sure you create a good image. Save it as a PNG with transparency so that you could use it as a watermark. Create a variety of them. You know, some with your name, some with your company's name, some with different things, copyright messages, whatever you want to do. And that way you can choose which one you want every time you run the shortcut.